grow moss animals a couple years ago, and we couldn't keep them in stock. And nobody does the faux moss better than you, but now you've added an element of stone to it that just made the manufacturing process exponentially more difficult because they're all painted by hand. But these stand out from even a distance. I think they are charming. All I have in front of me is the swan, but we also have a really cute rooster and a lamb, and I have fewer than 200 of either one of those. On the swan, I have a few more. Look at all that detail work. And these are nice and heavy in weight too.
Yeah, we wanted them to be durable enough to be outdoors, but definitely a decorator look that has a lot of texture in it. Yeah. And that's what I was able to accomplish with a team of amazing designers that work with me. And we were able to get that stone that is actually faux stone, although right. It looks real, it's magnesium. So when you feel that stone, Dan, doesn't it actually feel like real stone?
Yes, very much so.
The coloration in it too is so cool. So each piece is going to be a little bit different. Even the beak is on that swan is a beautiful hand painted. The eyes are very sweet. The lamb here that I have, oh, look at that green moss. Just love the way the light hits that. His eyes are sweet. It just looks like he's having a lovely day. This lamb, I have a fondness for lambs as well as bunnies, but this lamb in the lay down position is so sweet. The legs are tucked underneath the body, but look at the top. The entire thing is that faux stone, all done in different color variations, done completely around from head to toe, no matter what position you're looking or what angle you're looking at these pieces, you're going to see that they're just beautifully done and they look gorgeous from everywhere. I love the rooster, maybe in the kitchen. The green really accentuates whatever colors you have around it. So it doesn't compete with anything. It just looks fabulous with whatever colors you have. The feathers in the rooster are done in that magnesium faux stone. And you want to touch the stone. And people that come in the store, I find them petting the moss.
You have to.
Because that texture is something that your eye is so drawn to that you want to touch this. Like, that is amazing. Real moss is real hard to grow. So when we can do a faux moss that really looks real, sculptural, we are absolutely thrilled with that. Being able to bring this into our outdoor patio living, or we even love these inside the home. Inside the home, all of these pieces are just going to add whimsy. And outdoor, I love what you said, in nature, the unexpected is the most fabulous thing. So having something maybe tucked around a corner, maybe this is sitting at the mudroom door waiting to greet you to come in, or on a coffee table outside. That swan looks fabulous. The stone in the swan, that faux stone, I should say, the magnesium, it has gray tones and beige tones. So then that texture of that magnesium material against the soft look and the bright green of that faux moss is such a beautiful contrast that they go together perfectly.
Barbara, we started with 2,700, and at one point we had six different animals. We're down to three. So we've got the lamb, we have the swan, and then we also have the rooster. Those are the only three. Out of the 2,700 that we started with, we have less than 600 that are remaining. And the swan has been the most popular. The fact that this can sit outside and withstand the elements and the rain and beating down with harsh sunlight, and they still look fabulous. And you had mentioned that, you know, it's hard to grow moss. It's hard to grow moss where you want it. It's easy to grow it where you never wanted it. But to do something like this with real moss would be astronomically expensive. and so delicate it wouldn't last a season. People will have these for a long time.
Yeah, this is a special piece. I love that customers will send me pictures of where they're using their pieces. And I was blown away the other day. Someone had one of these. I think it was the lamb. Yeah, it was the lamb because it was laying down and had ivy spilling out of their urn with the lamb right on top. I'm like, that is the sweetest ever.
Nice.
That would make me smile every time I come to my door, having this textural thing, this piece that is softened by the flowers that you might put around this. It is that piece that you're not going to see everywhere. It is that boutique style piece that we just love designing and bringing to our customers here. The customers at the flower shop were going nuts, and truly the first thing, obviously people will see it, but then I see them walk right over and start to pet.
Yeah, you have to. It's like seeing a puppy. You have no choice. You have to fall in love with them. They're gorgeous.
They are.
Your next item is one of my favorites, and I don't currently have it for my own backyard, but I will be picking it up soon. It's just adorably cute. This is the 46-inch long dog bench. Up to a 300-pound adult